Good evening. We're so glad you joined us tonight for our Singspiration here at New Beginnings Chapel. You may notice that I'm here by myself tonight. My hubby is not feeling well, but we're not going to let that stop us from praising the Lord, so that we're glad that you're here, and we're going to get started with some singing, but we have a couple of announcements for you first. So we're going to get started tonight singing. We're so glad you're here. Wednesday nights are a great time when we sing these old hymns and songs that just bless our hearts. And so we hope that you'll enjoy tonight as we sing some of these familiar songs that may take you back a little bit to your childhood. But we're going to start off with Victory in Jesus.
I heard an old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life
Thank you tonight for your love and your many blessings, Lord Jesus, and the opportunity that we have to gather together over the internet and to sing these praises to you. Lord, it's just such a different time in our world right now. But Father, nothing can stop us from praising you no matter where we are. We can gather together over these airwaves, and Lord Jesus, we can just sing our praise to you tonight. So we thank you, Father, for that, and we give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. So I want to let you know that a little later in the service, we'll be having a time of prayer for prayer requests. And so if you have some prayer requests, you can text those to 509-309-0958. Or you can write those down in the comments below and we'll get those and we'll be sure to pray about those. Our staff gets together every Tuesday morning and we pray over those requests. And so if you have a request tonight, just go ahead and either text it into that phone number, 509-309-0958, or you can make them in the comments below and we'll see those a little bit later. And we're just glad that you have joined us here tonight. Want to let you know the few things that are coming up in a little bit. We'll give you those announcements, but I hope that you'll just sit back tonight and you'll relax and you'll join us in these songs.
Walking inside all of my journey over the mountains through the deep vale, Jesus has said, I'll never forsake thee. Promise divine that never can fail. Heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with bright sunlight, ever rejoicing, pressing my way to mansions above, singing his praises, gladly I'm walking, walking in sunlight, sunlight of love. Heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine.
Today as I looked out the window, I saw that it was raining and a little bit gray and dreary, but you know what? I'm so thankful for God's blessings. And our earth needs that. It needs that refreshing and that cleansing of the rain, just like our souls need the cleansing and the refreshing of God's rain upon us. And I'm so thankful for God's blessings and the showers of blessings.
There shall be showers of blessings. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we plead. There shall be showers of blessing. Send them upon us, O Lord. Grant to us now a refreshing. Come now and honor thy word. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we plead. There shall be showers of blessing. Oh, that today they might fall. Now is to God we're confessing. Now is on Jesus we call. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we plead. All praise to
that I would tell you about some upcoming things. We have some new guidelines for our state for our COVID-19 that our governor has issued, but we want to let you know that we are still okay and good to go for meeting in person here at the church on Sunday mornings. And if you would like to make a reservation, we are social distancing by family groups, and so we need you to make a reservation if you'd like to join us on Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. And you can do that by texting the word LOOP, L-O-O-P, and that gets you in the loop and lets you know all of those different reservations and all the activities that are taking place. You can text SEAT, and once you're in the loop, you can text the word SEAT, and you can give us your name and number of people that will be joining you on Sunday morning, and we will make sure that we reserve a seat for you. We've been pretty full these last few Sundays, and so it's really important, and we really appreciate you taking the time to make those reservations. And if you make a reservation and you find out on Sunday morning that you can't make it for whatever reason, just send us back a note on that same number, 509-309-0958, and let us know that you're unable to make it, and that will free up a seat for somebody. We had that happen this last week. A few people showed up that hadn't made reservations, and because someone had canceled their reservation, we were able to accommodate them, and so we really appreciate that. It's really important if you make that reservation and can't come that you let us know that so that we can make room for someone that really can be here. And so really appreciate you doing that and understanding. We're so excited to be able to get together and fellowship still in person. God is faithful, and it's just a great time that we get to be together and praise the Lord in person. So thank you for doing that. We really appreciate it.
See his face. Will you this moment
Father, we just come to you tonight. We're so thankful for your grace, Lord Jesus. And Lord, there's so many of you that are just feeling very isolated and very lonely tonight. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you would just reach down by your Holy Spirit and you would touch them and they would feel your Holy Spirit's presence sitting next to them tonight. Father, I know that these are very uncertain times and we don't know what's going to happen and seems like things change from day to day. But God, we know that you hold our tomorrows. You hold our todays. There's nothing that takes place, Lord God, that's out of your hand or out of your sight. Your word tells us, Lord Jesus, that all things work together for good, that those who love the Lord are called according to his purpose. And it also says, Lord, in your word that you began a good work in us and you will be faithful to complete it. So we trust you, Father. We trust you with our todays. We trust you with our tomorrows. And Lord, we pray for those tonight in our body that need a physical touch from you. Lord, I think of Jackie Cool just tonight, Lord God. She needs a touch from you. She needs a touch from the hand of her Creator. So Father, I pray that you would just reach down right tonight and just touch Jackie where she's at. Lord God, that she would feel the warmth of your Holy Spirit as it flows through her body. And Lord, that you would help her liver to begin to function the way that you created it to. And Father, we will give you all the praise and the glory for that. We pray for Cindy Kirchner tonight, Lord Jesus, and this cancer that has ravaged her body. God, we just come against those cancer cells in the name of Jesus. And God, we ask that you would put her body back into balance the way that you created to be, the way you created it to function. Father, so many that are recovering from surgeries and so many that are getting ready to have surgery. God, we ask that you would be with the doctors, give them wisdom. We think of Danny Conwell and Danita, for Ruth and for Kathy who've had surgeries, Lord God, and are recovering, and Danita and Danny who are getting ready to face surgery. God, give them peace and comfort. Touch them right now, Lord God. Our wish and desire would be that they wouldn't have to have these surgeries, but Lord, if this is your way of bringing healing to their bodies, Lord, we just pray that you would be with them every step of the way. There'd be no complications. And Father, again, we would see your hand at work in their lives. Lord, we pray for our country tonight. Father, there's so much confusion and division and anger and hatred going on. And Lord, we just pray that you would bring peace to our nation. To bring healing to our nation, Father, that we would be a people that would repent of the things that we have done, Lord Jesus, that are against your will. And Father, that you would hear our cry and you would heal our land. Father, we just ask these things now in your holy and precious name, and we'll give you all the praise and all the glory. Amen. It's a very familiar hymn. I would ask that you'd sing it with me tonight as we're going to be talking about grace here in a little bit and God's amazing grace. Isn't his grace amazing? I'm so thankful for God's grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saves. I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear. Grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear. Chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns. Unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good. As long as life endures, the earth shall soon dissolve like snow, the sun forbear to shine, but God who called me here below will be chains are gone, have been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns. Unending love, amazing grace. My chains are
Well, this past Sunday, my husband brought a message, and it was on God's grace, His past, present, and future grace. And so we're going to go over and we're going to do a little bit of table talk tonight. I have a special guest who's going to be joining me. And so first, we're going to give you just a couple more quick announcements, and we'll see you over at the table in just a minute. Joining me, Pastor Randy.
You're welcome.
For those of you that don't know, this is Pastor Randy. He is our team pastor here. And you've been with us for what, 12 years?
Yep.
12, 13 years?
Yeah, long time.
Long time. Actually, I think it is closer to 13 or 14 because my husband said Sunday that New Beginnings has been around for almost 14 years.
Yep.
In January, it will be 15 years.
Wow.
So, yeah, I think you've been here closer to 14 years. And so, long time you've put up with us.
It's been good.
So we do a little bit, I know you know, we do a little bit of birthdays and trivia.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to jump right into that. We have a couple of birthdays. Tiffany Detmer, and she is in our congregation, and today is actually Tiffany's birthday, so happy birthday to Tiffany.
Happy birthday,
if you're
Tiffany.
Watching tonight. We love you very much. And then this young lady is not part of our congregation, but she has been a dear friend of my husband and mine since we came here, oh my goodness, 26 years ago. Does that seem possible? We moved to Walla Walla. And her name is Roberta Bardsley, and she was in our choir at the congregation that we served. And so happy birthday to Roberta.
Happy
and
birthday.
So God bless you both.
Yes.
Wishing you very, very happy birthdays this week. Also have some famous birthdays. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready to go.
Okay, here we go. Famous birthdays. You know who that is? Mm-hmm. Any clue who that is, Pastor Randy?
Well, it's got to be one of my favorite characters of all time, Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse. That
yes.
is Mickey Mouse. And today is his birthday in 1928. And he has held up really, really well.
Yes.
There he is. That's him today. How come it is? Go back to the first one. How come it is there when, on his birthday in 1928, and that's today? He looks like he's getting younger, not older.
Yes,
good old
he does.
Mickey.
He
never ages. So happy birthday, Mickey Mouse. And this guy right here, do you know who that is? Any clue? I'll give you a clue. He's an actor.
That's a good clue. Wow.
He's done lots of movies.
Yep.
Born in 1968.
Did he play in one of the... Do I want to say National Treasure movies? No.
You're kind of close. Not National Treasure.
Not at the Museum.
Night at the Museum. That
right?
would be
yeah,
Owen Wilson.
Wilson. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you remember what his character? Who his character was in Night at the Museum?
I think he was a little short.
Yeah, it was a small part.
A small part. Yeah.
He was a miniature.
Literally, yeah.
He was a little toy cowboy in Night at the Museum. So happy birthday to Owen Wilson today. He was born 1968.
Wow.
We also do a little bit of today in history. You ready for some trivia?
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go.
I think, yep.
This right here, this guy. November 18th, 1307.
Wow.
So I would sing you a song right now that might help you if I went, never mind, I won't sing the song. Okay, so this guy right here is William Tell.
Okay, William Tell, okay.
Do you know what William Tell is famous for?
Telling stories. You know, I don't know.
Well, there's the William Tell Overture. That's what I was going to hum, but I won't do that. So he was famous for doing something. See what he has in his hand?
An arrow.
An arrow. He did this today in 1307.
Okay.
William Tell shoots an apple off of his son's head. Now, do you know why he did that?
No
clue. I did not know this. Okay, I don't know how many of you know this. Okay, so William Tell shot an apple off of his head because over in Switzerland where he was, there was an uprising to overthrow the government. And he was part of the resistance, okay, to this overthrow of the government. He ticked off the person who was in charge of overthrowing the government, whose name was Gessler. Okay? So Gessler had him captured and said he was going to kill him and his son.
Wow.
But he had heard that William Tell was this incredible marksman. So Gessler made him a deal and said, I won't kill you, I will save both you and your son's life if you can shoot an apple off the top of your son's head.
Wow.
So he did, and it split the apple. But then Gessler said to him, he said, I noticed that when you took the arrow out of your quiver, you took two arrows out. Why did you do that? And he said, well, if I had accidentally missed and killed my son, I was going to use my other arrow to kill you.
Oh.
Gessler was so mad that he said, I gave you my word that I would not kill you, so I won't. But he threw him in prison for the rest of his life.
Oh, wow.
So there you go. A little bit of trivia about William Tell shooting the apple off of his son's head today, 1307.
Wow.
I did not know that. So, okay. Next one, today in history. This lady right here, do you happen to know who she is? You're in the hot seat tonight, by the way.
Yeah, right. You know, wow, just I need to brush up on my history.
So this is Susan B. Anthony.
Ah, very good.
Okay. You know that she's on our coinage. Did
yes.
you know that recently, just not too long ago, a few months ago, President Trump pardoned her?
Oh.
Do you know why he pardoned her?
No.
Because today, November 18th in 1872, she committed a crime. She did something that was illegal at the time.
Hmm.
She marched into
let me get this place right. She marched into the registration office of Rochester, New York, and demanded to be added to the list of eligible voters. Oh. And it says that she mentioned to the gentleman there, she said she would like to be added to the list, and he said, well, I can't do that. And she said, are you familiar and acquainted with the 14th Amendment to the Constitution of the United States? And the registrar said he was, and she eventually persuaded him to add her to the list, and then she went in and she voted on November 5th with 14 other women, cast their ballots, and she voted in the race between Ulysses S. Grant and Horace Greeley, fully aware that her actions were illegal, and they promptly arrested her and threw her in jail, and her trial took place the following June.
Wow.
So she was arrested for voting in a presidential election.
And she was just pardoned.
And President Trump just recently pardoned her for that crime.
Wow.
So Susan B. Anthony, there she is. There's her arrested poster for voting in the presidential election. Isn't that interesting?
That's very interesting.
I think in light of all the things going on today, I think that's just real interesting that clear back in 1872. So we have one more. We've already mentioned Mickey.
Yep.
That today was his birthday, November 18th, 1928.
Yep.
Well, it was also the premiere of the movie, Walt Disney's Steamboat Willie.
Nice.
Premiered today, November 18th, 1928. So it was the first in sync sound and video or movie film.
Wow.
Were synced. It was the first cartoon that was synced where the audio and the visual were synced together. So,
wow.
1928. So, happy birthday to Mickey Mouse again. So, my husband preached a message on Sunday.
On grace, yes.
He did. On
Very
grace
good.
And the past, present, and future grace.
Right.
And we're going to talk about that in the second, but I wanted to start off tonight with just a little video here talking about grace. So, watch this
here
with us.
Here we go.
Mean to you?
Grace means to me that, it's, to me, it's like undeserved favor from God. I think that we need more of it in our nation. We need a lot more grace
with
in our nation.
With each other.
With each other, yes. But I thank God for grace because I don't deserve the grace that God gives us.
Yeah.
I can't imagine what all the Lord must put up with not only what's going on in the world today, but even within his churches. And I thank God for his grace. I thank God that when Jesus died on the cross, that his grace, even back then, was going to be extended clear out until the 21st century, to where people today didn't even know what was going on. Obviously, back then, now today, need grace more than ever.
You know, my husband shared that a little bit about the Hubble telescope, and yep. I know that you and I have both watched Louis Giglio's yep. Indescribable, yep. where it shows the Hubble telescope going out further and further and further, and you know the scripture that talks about how God holds the spans of those stars yep. between his fingers, and his grace, like you said, over the generations,
yeah.
From the beginning of time, from the creation of man, all the way through to eternity, where we're going to be with him, God's grace spans that. My husband talked about his past, present, and future grace. Now, when you hear past, yeah. present, and future grace, what do you think when you hear past, present, and future grace?
I think it just covers a multitude of past generations and future generations and generations that are happening right now.
There's a scripture. It's found in Psalm 116:10. It says, "With that same spirit of faith, we also believe and therefore speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead will also raise us with Jesus yeah. and present us with you in his presence. All this is for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God." Yep. You know, right now in our country, there's not a whole lot of grace.
Nope.
And this scripture says the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving. We're coming up to that holiday of
yes.
gratitude.
Yes.
Thanksgiving, and our time to be thankful for the blessings the Lord gives us. How do we extend that grace? How do we get people to see that grace? How do we give that grace to people? How do we get other people to extend grace?
I think by setting the example, I think people need to see a lot more kindness in the world today. I think we talked about earlier, even before the service started tonight, how there's so much confusion and there's so much division in our nation right now. And you know, and if we're honest about it, that's really what's going on right now. And you don't even, you just have to turn on the news or go to social media or something and just see everything that's going on in the world today. And in the midst of all of what's going on right now, people need to know that there's still grace out there. And this holiday season, especially Thanksgiving, Christmas coming up, I think we all need to be thankful for the blessings that God has given us. You know, a roof over our head, you know, food on the table, a job, a family, friends, stuff like that, a church that we can still come and attend to and be a part of. And I think the world today, right now, they are looking for an answer. And I believe that answer is grace.
Yeah, I think so too. I had someone tell me this week that they had a confrontation with a friend. They just made a statement that set this person off. And they said this person was so angry they were shaking, just literally shaking with anger just by a statement that they made. And it was a statement about what's going on right now in our country. And this person obviously was on the other side of the fence, and just anger immediately. I mean, it was like from 0 to 100, just yep. boom. Tensions are really high.
Yep.
Past grace is the grace that set us free.
Yes.
Set us free from bondage, and that bondage of our sin and everything that goes along with that. God's grace way back when Christ died on the cross and set
yes.
us free. Like that song we sang, "Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone." What kind of chains are we bound by? My husband asked that Sunday, and someone said addiction. I can't remember all of the different ones, but those chains that bind us, God set us free from those with past grace.
Yes.
The grace that he did on the cross. When you think of past grace, what other things come to your mind with past grace?
You know, I think of even before I accepted Christ, I believe that the grace of God was still extended to me. Even while I was yet a sinner, Christ died for me, right? And that's what the Apostle yep. Paul says. And I believe that even people today that do not know Christ, I believe God is still extending that grace and saying, I'm giving you an opportunity because I love you so much that no matter what you've done, and some people think, you know, I've done so many bad things, terrible things. Well, God doesn't gauge sin on different levels. Sin is sin to God.
Yeah.
Whatever it is. And God doesn't, you know, he doesn't gauge addictions. This is the worst addiction, that's addiction. And in God's eyes, it's all one level of sin and habits and hiccups and stuff like that. But God says, you know what? No matter what you've done in your past, I'm going to give you my grace, and I want you to accept it. And it's here's the thing, Pastor, it is freely
given. Yep, it's a gift.
Given.
Yep, it's a gift.
There's no strings attached. It's not like...
And we can't earn it.
And you can't earn grace. You know, the Bible says in Ephesians 2, I believe 8:9, it says, you know, for by grace are you saved through faith and not of works, lest any man should brag or boast. It is a gift of God, you know. And,
yep.
And God says, I'm giving you, I'm extending you this grace. So, you know, no matter how bad your past may seem right now, you know, God says, you know what, I'm going to extend my grace. It's waiting for you right now here in the present.
I remember when our youngest daughter came to live with us many years ago. she came to children's church, and your wife was teaching children's church. At the time, she was doing a series on God's top 10, which was the Ten Commandments.
Yes, yes.
And she came home about the third Sunday, and she was very frustrated. She was, I think, 7 at the time, and she was very frustrated. And she said, I can't do this. And I said, can't do what? And she said, there's just too many rules. There's too many sins. I can't do it. And I said, well, what do you mean? I said, there's only one sin. And she goes, Miss Kelly says there's at least 10. And she, you know, started to call off the different commandments that she could remember. And I said, sweetheart, let me ask you a question. I said, if God says, thou shalt not kill, and you kill, what have you done? And she said, disobeyed. And I said, and if God says, do not steal, and you steal, what have you done? Disobeyed. I said, if God says, honor your mother and father, and you don't, what have you done? Disobeyed. I said, there's really only one sin, sweetheart.
Sure.
It's yes. Disobedience, and mm-hmm. God sees it, as you said, all the same. But his grace at the cross yeah. broke that, and he gave that to us as a free gift.
Yes.
And now we stand firm in present grace. So what does present yes. grace mean to you, Pastor Randy?
Well, to me, it means that right now, God's grace is extended to us no matter, you know, what, you know, if we've fallen in sin, let's say, yesterday or a week ago or whatever, you know, and we repent of that sin, and we, you know, we say, God, I need your mercy, I need your grace, please forgive me. And we do it with all, I don't know, with all our heart, and not just say it by words. I believe God will extend that grace to us in the present, here and now, because we need, you know, all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Yep.
Even as Christians, I mean, we'd be fooling ourselves to say, you know, we don't sin, whatever, but we do. But here's the thing, is we have to realize that we have got to ask God for his grace, his mercy, his forgiveness, and keep moving forward.
Yeah, because this is a process.
It is a process.
And we go through life, and every day we are faced with challenges. We are faced
yes.
with things where we need to extend grace.
Yes.
But we can extend grace to those people in our present as we go and we confront those things, because God continues in our present to extend grace to us.
Yes.
And because it's a process and we are not by any means perfect yet, that takes us into future grace, because
yes.
we all know we have not arrived yet.
Exactly, yeah.
We are a work in progress.
Yes.
And we are going to continue to stumble. We are going to continue to trip up here and there, and we need that future grace. And so when we say future grace, to me, that's, you know, God saying, you know what? I see from the beginning to the end. It says that he is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And his grace runs from that beginning past grace where at the cross he set
yes.
us free from those bonds to our present, where we walk in his grace daily
yep.
because we need it, and extends into our future, because we don't even know what we're going to face
exactly.
in the future.
Yeah.
And
no
right
idea.
Now we have such an uncertain future. We have no clue what's coming. But I already know God's word says his grace is sufficient for whatever's coming.
Yes.
And that to me is very comforting.
It is.
I don't know about you, but I look to the future and I think, you know, it's good to know that God's grace is sufficient for me. And I mean, what does it say to you when you look at the future of what's happening and coming down, the uncertainty of things happening and knowing about God's grace?
I see it as a way of people being able to still live and walk, you know, a Christian life. Like you said, you said a key thing that, you know, we are going to stumble, we are going to sin. Do we do it on purpose? Hopefully not, you know, heaven forbid that we continue to sin, that grace may abound. That's what, in Romans, I believe it says it also. But I also believe that we have that grace that is extended, overextended to his people. And I think in a world in which we live today, we need to know and we need to be able to take comfort and hope in that, because, you know, right now people, you know, they feel like that, you know, they feel isolated, they feel alone, they feel this way, they feel that way. And all they have to do, and it's as simple as this, is they just have to say, God, I need your grace.
Yeah.
I need your help. God, because they're looking at the circumstances around them and they're saying, God, there's no hope. And God said, okay, I understand where you're coming from, but I want you to just say, give me more grace to get through this situation. You know, I mean, I think like even marriages, I think people on jobs, I think because of what's going on, I think anxiety levels are really heightened. And I think, you know, people can pit at one another and snap at one another. But, you know, God says, hey, you know what? Here's what I want you to do. I want you to stop. I want you to stop before you say anything. And I want you to think about my grace that I'm extending to you right now. And I want you to use that same amount of grace that I'm giving you, and I want you to extend it to the next person, whether it's your wife, your husband, your whatever, your relatives or your coworkers. I want you to extend that grace so they may see.
Yeah.
They may see that hope that they desperately need right now. If we don't extend that grace and we don't ask for grace, how can people see that there's any grace beyond what they have right now in their situation? Oh. There is none. They don't see it.
I saw on social media today that there was a brawl that had to be broken up in a Walmart somewhere in the Midwest because people got into a confrontation over the last pack of TP on the shelf. And they got into a knockdown dragout over TP. I mean, that's where we've come to.
Yeah.
Is we're fighting over toilet paper. It's God's grace. My husband pointed out, he said these things. He said, the promise of God's presence overcomes my weakness. It says in 2 Corinthians 12:9, my grace is sufficient for you because my power is made perfect in your weakness.
Yes.
And then he goes on to say, God's promise of supply will calm my anxiety, that anxiety that you you referenced.
Yes.
And it says, do not worry saying, what shall we eat? What shall we drink? Or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them.
Yes.
Matthew 6:31, Philippians 4:19, for my God will meet all of your needs according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. And then third, the promise of God's goodness secures my future. Psalm 23:6, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God's grace covers us from the past when he frees us by the work he did on the cross to our present, where we go through life and we meet those challenges and those things that we come up against and we feel like we're weak, we're incapable, we have that anxiety. God's grace is sufficient, and then his promise that he will carry us through, he will supply all of our needs, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God's grace, past, present, and future.
Amen.
And you have that grace, and it's a free gift. It's nothing that you can do to earn it. He gives it to you freely.
Yes.
And all you have to do is accept it. And so I'm so thankful for God's grace, and it truly is amazing.
It is.
I want to thank you, Pastor Randy, for being with us. We're going to wrap this up in a minute, but before we go, I have one more video that I want to share with you tonight about grace.
Grace is God's unmerited favor for us, his crazy love. And the truth is, many times we struggle understanding it. If you find yourself struggling to understand God's grace, don't beat yourself up. Even the disciples struggled with understanding grace.
Jesus, is that you? You're alive. I can't believe you're alive. Okay, I was in the boat and I wasn't catching any fish, okay? But I heard this voice and the voice said, cast your net to the other side. And so I'm thinking, I'm a fisherman. I know what I'm doing, but I'm not catching any fish, you know? And so I throw that net over there and then a gaggle of fish pop into that net and I'm going, this is a total miracle. Who could have done that? I need to know who told me to throw the net to the other side. And boom, I look up and I mean, there is you. You're looking at me on the seashore going, it is I, the Lord, and you're alive. I can't believe you're alive. This is awesome. Andrew, get out of the boat. Come on.
Peter.
Yeah.
Do you love me?
Yes, I love you. I love you. You're alive. This is so great.
Good. Then feed my sheep.
Andrew, get out of the boat. Come on, man. It's him.
Peter.
Yeah.
Do you love me?
I love you. Yes. And I'm so sorry about that rooster clucking. I had no idea what that meant, but I do not. I'm better for it. All right. Okay.
Good. Then feed my sheep.
Andrew, I'm smiling, but I'm serious. Come on, get out of the boat. It's him.
Peter.
Yeah.
Do you love me?
Jesus, mere words cannot describe the passion that I have for you. I love you. You know everything. I love you.
Good. Good. Then feed my sheep.
I didn't even know you had livestock. That is so like you, though. There's something new about you all the time. That's what I love about you.
Peter,
yeah.
Do you remember the morning the ladies went to the tomb?
Yeah. We're all in the upper room trying to figure out what to do next, you know, because we thought you were dead, you know, and we're trying to figure all that out, you know, and Mary comes running up and Mary's like saying, beehive, beehive, beehive. And I'm thinking, I'm allergic to bees, like keep them out, you know what I'm saying? But as she kept getting closer, I heard her correctly, she was saying, he's alive, he's alive, he's alive. And we're going, who's alive, who's alive? And she said, she was at the tomb and the tomb was empty. And she said that there was an angel there. And the angel said, go tell the disciples and Peter that everything is okay, he is risen. And so me and John, we hightailed it down there. And if John says he beat me, he's totally lying, all right? I beat him, FYI, all right, you know? And we get down there and I'm looking in that tomb and it is empty. There's nothing in there, you know what I'm saying? And I'm like, what does this mean? What does this mean? And John is right there. John is so good with words. He should write a book. He is so good with words. And John said, don't you get it, Peter? This is everything Jesus said he was going to do, and you did it, and it's done. Let's go. This is so great.
Wait, yeah. The angel said what?
Go tell the disciples and Peter that everything is okay. He is risen. You've risen. Let's go. This
he
is.
He said what?
Go tell the disciples and Peter. Go tell the disciples and Peter. You said my name. Why did you say my name?
Peter, that's grace.
No, I don't deserve that, because that night people kept coming up to me asking me if I belonged to you, if I was with you, and I kept denying you left and right, all right? No, it'll take me my whole life to make up for what I did. It was unforgivable for what I did.
No. What I did on the cross was meant to take what is unforgivable and make it forgivable. That's my grace. It's not about you. It's always about me. That's grace, Peter.
So, grace.
Yes.
That's grace. Doesn't matter how bad you mess up, God's grace is there for you.
Yes.
To set you free from your bondage and your chains. To walk with you no matter what you face every single day.
Amen.
And to be there with you in your weaknesses to come in your future, to help you through your anxiety of unsureness and where you're going, because God's promises that he will be there and he will be your strength and he will be all sufficient for you. Pastor Randy, would you close us out this evening in prayer?
Yes, I'd be glad to. Heavenly Father, as we come to a close of this Wednesday night table talk, and Lord, as we have talked about your grace, I believe that there might be some that may be viewing tonight that they've not experienced that grace yet. Maybe, as Peter said, I don't deserve it. I just don't deserve it. You know, and the Lord said, Peter, it's not about what you deserve. It's what I can give you. And so tonight I pray, Lord, that God, if there's anyone that's listening tonight, Father God, I pray, Lord, if they would just reach out and they would just say, God, I need grace. For whatever reason, God, I need it. I pray, God, you give it to me. I believe this in my heart, God. I believe this by faith.
that God, you will extend that grace. And God, there will be such a peace. There will be such an overwhelming peace, God, in their lives, in their hearts. It's unexplainable, but God, it's your grace from your Holy Spirit. And so tonight, I thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to share our senior pastor's message this evening with our pastor's wife. And I just pray, God, Lord, as we go in to this holiday season, God, that, God, if there's somebody out there, Lord, that we can extend grace to, we can speak a little kindness to, we can give a little grace to, I pray, God, that we will do that and make their day and their week just a little bit better. Again, Lord, thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Well, thanks for joining us tonight. Yes. I know my husband has been watching from his quarantined sick bed. And so thanks, honey, for watching us. And for the rest of you, we hope that you'll make a reservation. Again, 509-309-0958. Join us Sunday morning right here in person at the sanctuary at 10:30 a.m. And so from all of us here at New Beginnings, we just want to say have a blessed week and enjoy God's grace. Good night.
Good night.